God to sleep. Al-Imam al-Abir, I will refer to this author as Al-Imam al-Abir, he states, في هيئة المنام. So he states, في هيئة المنام اعلم أن النوم رحمة من الله على عبده. Know that sleep is a mercy from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon his slave. Many students of knowledge, like myself, ask, how many hours should we sleep? I say to them, it doesn't matter how many hours you sleep, it matters what you do when you are awake.
Subhanallah.
Your body will need as much sleep as you need, especially when we are young, from the ages of 20 to around 35, our bodies need more sleep. As we grow older, our bodies need less sleep. So do not worry about how many hours you sleep and how much you eat. Worry about what do you do when you are awake. And attending classes is sufficient, attendance of classes with 20 minutes revision every day. If someone attends classes and revises for 20 minutes every day, this is sufficient. They do not need to do more study than this. But people have other concepts in their mind, thinking that you need to study 8 hours a day. So they attempt this for a few days, then they leave studying totally. So they should attend classes and revise 20 minutes every day consistently. Consistency is better than attempting to study and trying to read for 8 hours and then giving up after a few weeks. So he states, sleep is a mercy upon the slave. When you read the stories of the awliya of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the previous ages, remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them a soul, a ruh, so powerful that sleeping for less hours was easy for them. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created you like this, then you can follow that manhaj, that pattern. But making it difficult upon yourself is not something that the sharia, the divine law, demands of you. You sleep and eat in accordance with the needs of your body. This is something many ulama have highlighted, including Abdul Rahman ibn al-Jawzi, rahmallahu ta'ala, in his book Sayyidul Khatir and many other works. So, why is this mercy of sleep granted to the slave? لِيَسْتَرِيحَ بِهِ بَدْنُهُ عِنْدَ تَعْبِهِ. In order that his body can have rest when it is tired. لَمَّا عَلِمَ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ عَجْزَ الرُّوحِ عَنِ الْقِيَامِ بِتَدْبِيرِ الْبَدَنِ دَائِمًا. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knew that the soul is incapable of administrating the needs of the body all the time. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created sleep. فَالنَّوْمُ هُوَ أَبْخُرَةٌ تُحِيطُ بِالرُّوحِ الْمُدَبِّرِ لِلْبَدَنِ. That sleep is fumes that surround the soul, that soul which administers the body and make the soul fall asleep. فَتَحْجِبُهُ عَنِ التَّدْبِيرِ. These fumes cover the soul and then the soul is no longer able to administer the body and the person falls asleep. This is the concept of sleeping. وَمَا هُوَ فِي الْمِثَالِ إِلَّا كَالْمَلِكِ إِذَا حَجَبَ نَفْسَهُ عَنْ تَدْبِيرِ مَمْلَكَتِهِ لِيَسْتَرِيحَ وَتَسْتَرِيحُ أَعْوَانُ فِي وَقْتِ حَجْبِهِ. He states, its similitude is like the king. When the king is administrating the country, when he has time to rest, he goes to rest himself, and the administration, the people around him also go to rest. This is how the soul is. So the soul needs rest. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created abkhura, which is fumes. These fumes go into the mind and you feel them in the mind, but they are all of the body, and this is sleep, and then the person falls asleep. This is the concept of sleeping.